Hey guys, Johnny Nerd out here. Got another customer e-bike build. I'm gonna go over what bike this is, what the customer wanted, and what components I used. If you're new to the channel, I'm Johnny Nerd out. I'm a e-bike nerd. I build them, I repair them, I maintain them, and then I make videos about them. I'm a nerd. So let's get into the video. This is a Specialized Roll Sport. I really like this bike. This is such a cool bike and it rides super nice. It's got 650B by 2.3 tires, so they're big and thick. I don't know why you just feel like you could go over anything on this, even though they got road tread tires, like they're treaded for your road. You just feel like you could go anywhere on them. They're big and round. Yeah, and just the handlebars sit up high. It's got like a cool extended raised handlebar. It just rides really comfortable. It rides real solid. This is a perfect e-bike candidate, and I love riding this thing around. It's got disc brakes. It's got a Mega Range gear in the back, which is perfect for climbing or just cruising slow. It does have Shimano tourney derailleurs, which is, you know, low end, but it works fine for this. As long as they were spending money for this, they wanted just the best bike they can get. They didn't need anything crazy though, so we went with the BBS02 Bafang motor. It's super reliable, super powerful, and it's really efficient. And for the battery, we chose a 52 volt, 17.5 amp hour using Samsung 35E cells. This is gonna give him a really long range, and the premium cells, this thing should last a really long time with proper care. For the display, he wanted a nice color display, so we went with the 500C display. It's an all-in-one unit, so the buttons are on the display, which is nice. You don't have to run separate wires and add more wires to the already numerous wires that are added to the bike, and it shows you all the graphical data like watts in real time, your speed in real time, and you know, average speed, maximum speed, all the goodies like that. And it's just a nice looking display. Because this one has a all-in-one brake and shifter lever, I had to run an inline brake cutoff, which is kind of nice. That means you don't have to get rid of the shifter that's already there just to, you know, add a brake cutoff onto it. So the inline brake cutoff was really nice. I was able to keep the parts that were already in really good shape. And the only other add-on I did was I added a gear shift sensor that just cuts the power momentarily while you're shifting. It's going to take really good care of the chain and the whole drivetrain, really, the rear sprockets, and keep those teeth looking nice. Think of the gear shift sensor as a dentist. Hope you guys like this video. Hope you guys like this bike. I freaking love this bike, and I'm gonna probably, if I ever find one of these, I'm gonna probably end up buying one of these because this is just a fun ride. Leave comments below. Let me know what you think. Let me know your thoughts. And hopefully you found this video helpful. Hit that subscribe button, y'all. Later.